playing video games and all that stuff. And like, I don't just play video games just to play video games. I don't just watch anime just to watch anime. It's the imagination of just knowing that the world is so big and there's so much more. And that's the shit that really pushes me and drives me to want to like, yo, there's more for me, you know what I mean? I don't even know how I need to introduce myself, really. Well, Miro LaFlaga, what do I do? I am a creator, artist. I'm just a person who's just living and just going through life right now and just figuring it out as I go through. A lot of people don't know that. Like, I was originally born in Uptown. So like, I was originally born in Uptown and lived in Uptown, you know, the first 4 years of my life. And then, you know, we moved to DG, and that's where like my life really started, honestly. The first like form of art that like really changed me and just really captivated me, it was hip hop. And I just think music in general. My mom would clean the house on Sundays. So Sunday morning is made for cleaning the house. So you have to get up. I'll wake up and my mom is playing Toni Braxton, you know what I'm saying? Whitney Houston, Sunday morning, you know what I mean? Michael Jackson. That's how my Sundays were. Like, my mom would play music Sunday mornings to clean up the house. So at a young age, like, we're always like surrounded with music and stuff like that. And like, because my sister was older, she was really into hip hop. I was watching music videos. I used to record music videos on the VHS. Seen Puff in the shiny suits and Mace. Like, you can never tell me that Mace was not the flyest motherfucker ever. Like, I grew up on that. Just growing up in NDG as a whole, like, I was just surrounded by just different people from just different cultures. And I think that was the sickest thing, you know what I mean? Like, my homies were, you know, Congolese, Chinese, you know what I mean? Persian, Romanian. Like, that was my upbringing. It was just being around so many different people. And I think that's why I was, at a young age, I always had a very open mind. When I was younger, like, I was not too like aware of it as much, you know? It's when I got older, I started like really realizing like how much it is, you know, the English folks are kind of like oppressed in a way here in the city. You have to think about it, right? A lot of the English folks who are growing up, especially Black minority who's growing up, you know, their aspiration is to go to the States or go to Toronto. Subconsciously, that need of like, oh, I want to leave or go somewhere else, it comes from the fact that like you're English here and you don't feel like belonging subconsciously, but you don't realize it, you know? And specifically for me and my career, my journey, like, I'm fortunate enough because I speak French, you know what I mean? So like, I was able to like maneuver the system, you know? I went to a French elementary school and went to a French high school. Regardless of that, I still don't feel like I was still part of the system, because ironically enough, the only time I really spoke French is like it was in a institution setting. Also about the culture too. I would speak to like Quebecois and they would tell me some show on TVA, and it's like, yo, I never watched TVA in my life. I know what it is. But it's like, bro, I have BT, like I have UPN. I have these other channels, like why am I watching TVA? Or like these like Quebecois singers that I'm not familiar with. When I was growing up, they weren't familiar with none of that. It's only recently that people were talking about these people named Marie-Mé or something like that. And they're like, yo, that's such a big person from Quebec. And I'm like, I don't know who that is. Like, I had a moment in my life where like I didn't really know who I was. Like, I was kind of lost, you know what I mean? And I was around different individuals that were kind of like, you know, we were kind of in the same boat. We were trying to kind of figure out life as well too. People who sold crack, people who sold, you know what I mean, who did fraud. I think the reason why I was just around that environment is because, like, I just didn't know who I was and what I wanted in life. And I think that's the reason why I went through this rough patch of my life where I was like trying to, I didn't know who I was, I was trying to discover myself because I realized I was just doing all of this. But when I kind of like let go of that and I just really showed up as who I am right now today, in terms of my interests, in terms of the shit I'm into, and like just me being me, the way I talk, the way I just carry myself, this is like my like most authentic self ever. I think that's one of the reasons why like I even went in this career and I pushed myself to kind of just be an artist of some sort. I just started expressing myself because I got tired of just being confined in this box. Bro, like when I started this career, bro, like I had literally $5,000 in my bank account. I save up 5 racks, bro. And I literally just quit my job and quit everything and I just invested that money myself. Anyone who knows me or anyone who's gonna be watching this, they would tell you like I always been the most flyest person ever. I was rolling with my boy O at the time and he was doing his whole spoken word thing and he was just like, you know, like, yo, bro, like, why don't you style me? I started building content for myself, bro. Literally, like I used the money and I was hiring photographers and videographers. I built a little website and I was just putting myself out there on my social. Styling went from me creative directing. And then that's when I was like, okay, styling's kind of boring. I don't really like that shit. Like, I like making myself look good, but I don't really like making another person look good. I got drive of like, building content. You see people who create content and you think, oh, that shit is so easy, but you don't realize the work that goes behind it. And I was unaware of the work that goes behind it. So when I started working with all these different creators and they showed me like all of this, I'm like, I don't have the patience for this. I don't have the patience to look for fonts. I don't have the patience for this. A real thing that I'm really good at is like bringing people together and just kind of like pushing everyone towards that vision. I was growing, I wanted more for myself, and I was understanding the rules to the game. That's where the switch really happened, where it's like, okay, well, I like, yo, we need to build this agency. We need to make this shit legit. We have to make sure that we know how to present ourselves looking official and give people all the reasons to say yes and no reasons for them to say no. Love would change a man, you know what I mean? That's one thing I would say, like, but beyond the love aspect, I think the big shift was also like, I knew at the end of the day that this matrix, the system that we're in, there's a way you have to maneuver, you know what I'm saying? Why Brandon? Is because Brandon is what I was doing since the beginning. I brand myself without me even noticing it. Like, you know, like the way I am, it's, this is personal branding, you know? And like, when I was like, you know, styling other artists and doing videography and photography and all that stuff, that was a branding, you know? And when I met Ash and she was doing graphic design work and stuff, that was a form of branding. The biggest milestone was to sink in was like the fact that like, yo, me and Ash was in it full time. Like, this is literally what we do, nothing else beyond that. And that was it. Getting to work with, you know, Will Smith's company, Westbrook, you know, that was a big milestone. Winning several awards, you know, being recognized by Applied Arts for the projects that we did, and RGD, you know, that was very big as well too. Getting featured in Ad Week, you know what I mean? Big US, one of the biggest US marketing publication. Also, yo, a big milestone is the fact that like, yo, we went to Denmark for our, went to Denmark. That, I think that's a pretty cool one, you know? I think that's very inspirational for like, for a kid like me from NDG, bro, to get flown out to Denmark to do a presentation on branding. I did not even study for this subject. I think that's super amazing. To me, it was very sick, man. Like, I think it was, that was a milestone for real, for real. That was cool, like being out in Copenhagen. I'm always pronouncing this, not pronouncing properly. Please don't kill me. like I was telling you before, like growing up in NDG, you only know that area. You only know your area. You only know that. So like to see, just for me in my context, I think it's just very open. It's very inspirational. Like I'm making that like being very wide, like and people could see it in real time happening. I think it's very inspirational. Is love the conductor of my success? 100%, bro. Love in all facets, bro. Love for my woman, love for my family, love for my community, love for my people. I feel like my entire life I was moving out of fear, in terms of fear of like not having and wanting more, the fear of losing and stuff like that, you know. And that was a big motivator of my success, I should say. I think I'm just moving out of like just being love with the sport, being love with doing what I'm doing, you know what I mean? He's done miracles on me. 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 He's done miracles on me.